something else, even though now he decided to go study this one. So he's a graduate of international relations from the University of Lagos. But now he's a filmmaker, a director, a scriptwriter, a producer, and he's popularly called Wonto. But his father, or his parents, named him Ide Chukwuma Innocent Wonto.
It's okay.
Are you one of those who got a degree in whatever it was for your parents and you went home and you said, Mom, Dad, here is your degree.
No, it didn't actually happen like that.
Okay.
Tell us how it happened.
I'll tell you, growing up, I'm the last of four. My father was a soldier. I wanted to be a lawyer. That's the whole beginning. Whenever there's a conflict or dispute in the house, then...
Blessed are the peacemakers.
Yes, I actually don't make peace. I give the verdict.
That's different, isn't it?
So I wanted to be a lawyer so much. Then somehow, after my secondary school did my exams, I stumbled into international relations, you know. But while all this was happening, there's something that has always been part of me. Growing up, my father's office, there's a guy who's into photography. His office is just right by my father's office. So I would leave his office. I was always stuck with the photographer guy. I knew how to use his camera. Then I started taking pictures for him. So while in school, even in secondary school, I was taking pictures for people, getting paid for taking pictures. I picked up a music career at some point. I was shooting my own music videos and shooting for other people. So it was something that was in me that... I kind of was taken for granted, or maybe I didn't really know what it was. So it got to a point in my life when I felt like this international relation thing, they would tell you, in 1708, the old Oye Empire once, I wasn't born then, I don't care what happened there. So, you know, I decided to, search inside of me, what is that thing that I really love to do? And I knew there was something about cameras and me liking to film a couple of stuff.
So you something about cameras, but you now decided to instead start going to filmmaking. You didn't think you should do photography. You just wanted to go directly to filmmaking.
Yeah, I wanted to because it moved from just photography into motion picture, making the music videos and stuff. So... at the point when I wanted to decide, I also stumbled into working for Silverbit at some point. But it got to a point like, okay, you know what? I think I really want to not just do this thing, but really get to master the craft. So I left for South Africa, where I get to do a proper training course on film. Then I came back, this is nice. And then I left for California again to do a master class at ABL City in Burbank. And that's how we...
That's how you roll.
Well, but it's never been a mistake. I feel fulfilled. I think that's one thing I would do. You pay me, you don't pay me. I love to work.
So if I come now and I tell you I have a script and I want to produce it and I don't have money...
I've never been... Money is important. Money is important, but I've never been moved. I've never been... My staffs will tell you I'm not moved by... what I have in my bank account. We've done a full project when we have zero balance in our account. The same way we've done a full project when we have millions in our account. So I'm never moved by... the money don't inspire me.
Okay.
Now, where did this love for motion picture originate?
It's like I said, it was part of me until I really got to discover it was part of me. And you see, when you do something...
It was part of you until you really discovered it was part of you.
So when you do something you love, when you are not compelled, if I was a lawyer, I don't think I would have succeeded. If I became an ambassador as an international relation course was going to take me around that line, I don't think... I love French... But I never loved to. I didn't really like learning how to speak it, Dutch and all that. It wasn't my thing. And when you tried to give me those history books, I wasn't just feeling it. But film, I see it as
you were at home,
a way of expressing myself. I can go to it was any direction. I can tell any story I want. I can,
in a way that you want, choose to,
the way I choose to. I can sit in my world and I can create anything, and I can decide to express it. It's fun. It's beautiful.
I'm loving you.
And at the end of the day,
you get paid for it.
I get paid for it. You know what I'm saying?
For doing what you love.
For doing what I love. So when I can assure you 99.9% of when I go on a project, the last thing I think about is
the naira,
how much
the
do
cobble.
I get back? It never occurs to me.
Okay. It You've never worked does. With some fantastic, well-known, established actors and actresses, including Segun Arinze, Fred Amata, Kiki Omeili, Tina Mba. Oh, yes.
I think you're still backwards.
Oh, okay. So give us the new ones, then. Please bring us up to date.
The vibe. Yeah, I've been lucky. You know, I've really been lucky. I've been blessed to work with some exciting, amazing people, from the top to the bottom. It's been fun. So.
Well, okay, so give us some names.
No,
we're outdated.
We're outdated. So update us. Give us like three.
Okay, presently I'm working on some. Okay, I just finished a TV series called Holy Grail. It's a story on the corruption and things behind the fight to own and control crude oil in Africa. So I created a company called Nectar Oil. See, that's what I say. You can create anything. So Nectar Oil, and we have people who are battling to take control of Nectar Oil. And we have pretty much a lot of amazing people, from Segun to Zach Oji to Caroline Danjuma to... I work with India, there's a lot of people, but we also presently, September this year, we're filming, I'm working on a project called Pillars of Africa.